So last week I did a video on setting up Time Machine. So once you have it set up, it just runs automatically and it backs up your Mac every hour. And there are two possible uses for that backup. One is if a complete disaster strikes, like your Mac is stolen or destroyed or the hard drive fails, you can then choose when you set up a new Mac to restore from that Time Machine backup. And it will prompt you to do that. The other use, though, is to restore a single file, a group of files, that you may have accidentally deleted or maybe modified in such a way that you really want the old ones back. So let's take a look at how to do that. I've got a folder here called Projects. And in this folder, you'll notice a gap in the icons. What I did is I created this folder a few days ago and I filled it with some sample files. And then yesterday I deleted a file and I emptied the trash. So it's gone. And now today I realize I made a horrible mistake and I need that file back. So how do I get it back? Well, I of course have been backing up with Time Machine. It's been backing up every hour. So I should be able to go back in time and find that file. Now if this was a clone backup, a clone being just basically a duplicate of your hard drive, and I had backed up last night to this clone, then I wouldn't have any hope of getting this file back because my backup last night wouldn't include this file. So it wouldn't be on my backup. But since Time Machine does these incremental backups and saves a history, it's going to have a copy of this file if I go back in time far enough. So let's go and enter Time Machine by clicking on the Time Machine icon up here, and you can see that there's the option to enter Time Machine. I'll do that. Now I'm doing that with that Projects window open in the Finder, so it knows this is what I want to focus on. So now I see multiple projects folders going back in time. And on the right side I see a timeline. And I can use these arrow keys to go back in time. So this is now showing me right now what this folder looks like. If I click here, it will go back and it will show me earlier today. And I can continue to go back and it will show me each snapshot. And I can go through this morning and keep going back. And you can see the file's still not there because I deleted it yesterday. Now I can speed this up a bit by going to the timeline and saying let's go all the way to yesterday and let's go yesterday morning. I'm pretty sure the file was there. So we'll go yesterday morning at 10:24 a.m. and there it is, the timemachinetest.txt file. Now I want to restore this file, so I'll click it. And now at the bottom I've got a cancel and a restore button. If I hit restore, it's going to pull that file from the drive and place it back in the folder. So now I've successfully pulled this file from a day and a half ago. Now I can also do this with an existing file. So I could have pulled an older version of the file and it would give me options whether or not I want to keep the just the original file or the new one and the old one together, so you know it doesn't automatically overwrite what you've got there. But you can go and grab an older version of file. So say if it was a document you're working on, you deleted some text from it, or deleted part of an image in a Photoshop document, something like that. You could actually go back and pull that older version and have both the current and the older version, and then go and copy and paste from one to the other to fix your mistake. So that's the basics of how you pull a file from Time Machine. Now I have some homework for you, because the last thing you want to do is use this for the first time when you really need it. So I want you to do what I did. Create a sample folder, fill it with some text edit documents, then remember tomorrow maybe to delete a file or two from it, and then the next day go and use Time Machine to go back and recover that file. See how it's done so you have confidence that you can do it when the time comes to recover a file that you may have accidentally deleted.